Hi guys, and welcome back to my food island way, Nicolas Food. Haven't seen you guys for a while now. Just a little bit busy and and life. But hope you're all well and safe, and enjoy your weekend. It's a weekend again. And yeah, I'm about to cook some food. I've got a shark here. Doom, 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 doom. I've got a little shark. You know, it's already clean from the shop. All I have to do is get rid of the skin and fill it. I'm going to make some, some fish and chips. You know, if you're living in Australia and in New Zealand, so you must have sharks before, because that's the main thing. Main thing that they use for fish and chips is little small sharks. The skin is very sandpaper. I don't like touching it. I'm gonna clean it up and make some fish chips. Before that, I'm gonna show you my bit of video I made my mom and my friends some lunch before, you know, outside. But now, that's the other day, there's a puppy holiday. But today, I'm just gonna make a fish and chips out of shark. And show you how to make it. And I'm having some fresh potatoes, I'm gonna make some fresh chips to go with it. Fish and chips. Let's start cooking, guys. Hey guys, so welcome back, and we start cooking. Making mum's and dear friend a quick lunch. Okay, we've got some fresh fish here. It's clean cut, gutted, and scale. This is a frozen abalone, the baby ones. Gonna go on a charcoal barbecue, and some cocos here. All fresh and going on the barbecue. There's some scallop. Been frozen, and I'm gonna defrost it and go on the barbecue. There's some taro boil. There's some chicken here. I'm gonna defrost it and make a mushroom corn soup. Okay, there's corns there. There's some lemon, and there's some mushrooms in there. Okay, let's do this. Guys, I'm gonna peel some taro. There's a lot of bruise on here on this tar. Whatever, and people throw them around. I have to tell that to them. The workers throw the tarros around like a... It's a kalo niwe. The main salmon tar. I'm just gonna boil them. No coconut cream. So keep it healthy for the old people. You can use asi, or you just use a potato peel. And all our seafood is going on now. What do you call? The charcoal barbecue. You need a big potato peel. Okay, I'm gonna slice this up in round pieces and start cooking it. Just boil it. Put a little bit of salt in there to stop from going chilly. Okay, back in a minute. Guys, welcome back. I've got a bit of oil in this bowl. Just a vegetable oil. And I'm gonna slice a bit of spring onion. Very small. This is sauce for our fish. To crush our fish on it. On our fish, so when it's cooking. While it's cooking. taro is starting to boil. Got it in rings, very small. Okay. So a little bit of seasoning sauce in there. It's a bit of color and flavor. This will brush on top of our fish while it's cooking, our seafood. And bit of a veggie flavor, veggie salt. Give it a stir. Okay, I'm gonna add a half a lemon. And that's it. Mix it all nice. And it'll brush on top of our fish while it's cooking. Okay, I'm gonna go out and light my fire now. My thing there. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, here's the soup. We're putting on flavor for the chicken soup. I'm sweating from my soy lying that thing. I need to wipe the table down. Okay, the water is warm and boiling. We're adding this chicken now. It's only a light soup for mom and her old friend. Is that enough?
Yeah, that's it for
now. Okay, then we add, we add more things, corns and mushrooms and spring onion. Okay. Hey guys, welcome back. Our soup is on. Now I'm gonna brush this flavor oil in there. All the seasoning. Just make it suck into the fish what is there in there. Turn it over. Ow. Charcoal stove outside is going on. It's going on. Put a little flavor in, and then you got a lot of oil in there, flavor oil here to brush it on while you're cooking. That's it guys, just let it sit in there and brush more oil on it before you put it up on the stove. But I think I'm going to cook one at a time because our fish fin's small. Okay guys, now we took the chicken out and add some ginger and take the meat off the chicken, off the bone. And in ginger, the salt already in there, and the flavor. I'm gonna add the chicken now. And chicken meat. Oh, steams always seems to come into the camera. Yep. And spring onions. Maybe everything now.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mushrooms. Just cut it small. Maybe it's in the corn. It's a cream corn. Adding two in there. And then turn it down low and cook it similar slowly.
Don't want to boil it. Boil it will go thick.
Not Trent, no.
Okay. So let that simmer and we'll get back in a minute. And guys, here's our fish. It's about to go in the hot coals. Put more of that oil on it. Turn it over. I really put oil on before. That's it. A little bit of salt. And that's it. I'll put it on the heat now. The heat's very high. That's alright, we can turn it over very quick. Okay.
Then I'm gonna put the tray down there and just get them on there.
What?
As you drop it, that's fine.
I'm not gonna put it.
Okay.
Then he's got it. There you go, the fish. Fish on that hook.
Yeah. Okay, good. Now, if I wanna put it down, I put it down like this. Now it is not very loud.
Yeah.
Correct?
Very loud.
It's not very loud. So that's how you put it up and down. Okay?
Yeah.
Let's cook. Got the shell holder hit. A little power. Or abalone, farmed ones, that's why they're small, otherwise you can't eat that legally, but they're farmed. Otherwise they want to eat the rest raw.
Yummy scallops. Lemon, spring onion, and olive oil.
Two for right there, leaving there.
Okay.
Two for right.
Make sure that always you good now from the.
The guys are all done. There's a scallop. There's a plate of food for next door. The old people. Some carlo. So chicken soup,
this one here,
pork chop,
no,
and there's some fish.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Keep going.
And they decided to eat this raw.
Keep going. Keep going.
No,
keep
it's
going.
Still alive when you touch it. So. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now pushing the one in the middle.
They're fixing
the middle.
Hearing stuff.
Yeah.
See, this is restaurant.
Oh yeah.
If you're sitting with people in a restaurant.
Oh yeah.
Sometimes the restaurant makes too much noise from people.
I think
people.
The restaurant is number three.
And this one here, outdoor. Outdoor.
Yeah, that one.
Because it's a shock. See. You're gonna need a Stanley knife. And to pop the skin, because the skin is really, really leathery. Look at the skin, guys. Use the other knife too. You really need this standing knife. You need to cut through the skin. All the way down to the line, to the bones. See, you need to you can see what I'm doing, guys. Go all the way down to the tail. Oh. It'll take a while here, guys. But it's a shock. You know, it's a shock. Need to go I think you're going to need a knife that sending knife that keep look for safety this way. It's like that. And I'm gonna use a normal knife now. Just go all the way down. Just follow the bone. Yeah. Just gonna feel it. And follow the bone, guys. See? I'm cutting this one side to show you. Yeah? So I can make a mess on the whole piece. And guys, I'm gonna lay this down and then cut the meat off. Show you. And I'm trying my best. You really need a sharp knife, guys. Look the mess I made. If I had a really sharp knife. So I'm gonna just clear a bone off here and off the stomach. And then I'll fill it for our fish and chips. It's only a small shark. Okay, I'm gonna clean up the other side and I'll be back. This time I clean the shark, guys. Even guys real fishermen. I saw them clean the shark and they were even struggle. But with me, no struggle straight here, mate. Because we get our pieces of shark. And of course, we're going to cook it, fry it, Then some fresh chips go with it. Okay, that's all the shuck. And why not? I'm feeling a bit of bone in there, but I'm just gonna leave it. You can pick it up when it's ready or something. See? Carry on with your shucks. Oh, gosh. Shuck fins, they can eat us. They have no idea we've been eating them on fish and chips for them. You know? Hey guys, here's our shucks, all clean. Shuck meat. So I'm just gonna cut and make a not too big pieces. It's about that big. Easier to batter and fry it. When I'm working on make our chips. This is gonna be one yummy fish and chips. Put it in the fridge, okay. Because just a little bit of salt, sprinkle of salt around it. Just salt your meat. Potatoes here. I'm trying to use the longest potato and the big potato so I can make our fresh chips. So I'm just gonna peel it and cut it up. And half boil them and then let them cool down and drain the water before it fries. Make our chips. Ready peel? I'm just gonna cut it long ways. If you can get a pickled potato, that'd be nice. See? Let's cut it that size. We're making our water. Try to make it the same size so they can all cook at the same time. Let it stand back. All been washed and added in there. Now, with a little bit of salt. Okay, let it bring it to the boil. Once it boils for 2 minutes, take the water out and let it dry. Okay, for 2 minutes. Now it's, let it dry and cool down before we make our chips. Pitty, what are you doing? What I'm gonna need is a seasonal all purpose. A little bit. Okay, let's mix it up around. I'm gonna add this bit of plain flour again. That's where our fish, we're gonna dip our fish into before we dip it into our batter. Okay. Little bit of salt. That's all you need. Mix it around. Okay. We got our chips here, it's gonna go in our oil over there. But our oil here is for our fish. Our shuck. To the flour. Dust with your family or the kids. And show the kids how to make fish and chips. Smells so good. Smells beautiful. I'll be back in a minute. I think I'm going to check on our chips. I usually mix self-raising flour and plain flour. I made a mistake there. I didn't add a plain flour, self-raising flour. So I'm going to add more water in there. But it still tastes good. Still, but I want it puff. little bit of puff in our fish. Bit of more fish in there. I think our chips is ready, guys. Half of our chips, it's ready. One more fish. Cats are coming in at dinner time. Hey there. See, guys, how this one is floating? Like I tell you, I forgot to add the flame flour. Oh, the self-rising flour. Hey guys, here's our chips is ready. I'm trying to hurry because people are watching a movie and yeah, run and drop them. Bit of chicken salt. But still yummy. Hey guys, our fish and chips is ready now. Some chips. And yeah, little fish, yummy, juicy, moisture, very delicious. That's it. Bit of salt and a bit of chicken salt and we're going to eat. Okay, thank you for watching and thank you for watching me making fish and chips. I'll see you in the next video. Much love and God bless. Stay safe and stay well. Goodbye for now, guys.